certainly knew them. A little quick taste of their soon-to-be entitled album, Voice of a Rebel. But tonight they're pairing it right back down with a gorgeous REM cover for us. We'll see that in a couple of minutes' time. I think you'll really love it. Before that, let me do this. Our viewer competition tonight promises a lavish prize package for you and your nearest and dearest to enjoy. It's a luxury three-night stay for two at Powers Court Estate and Gardens in Enniskerry. You'll stay.
That's right.
I want to get straight down to business because I've been following you and what you've been saying, and you waded in 4 feet forward and into the COVID debate. You just felt you'd had enough or something. Why did you decide we're going to get stuck in here?
I just feel like there was so much misleading information online. You had figures that people looked up to over the years who had followed, and they were coming onto their Twitters and their social platforms and saying these statements, and I feel it was throwing the people, and we just felt like we had to come on and voice our opinion because I feel we all have voice.
I think a lot of people didn't have the balls to tweet about it. I was like, I'm saying what I feel. It's been many years. Like, I stand for all these things. Let's get it out to the people and let's know what we stand for, because it seems like there's people on this side, that side, and there is only...
And it's the present day. Like, this is such a big deal in the world. The whole world has come to a stall because of this whole pandemic.
So you got kind of fed up, did you, looking at people that you admired saying what you felt were crazy things, and you said, come on, lads, don't, that's not what the story is.
Like, it's bringing people together, and we all just have to, you know, follow the guidelines, wash our hands, wear the mask, and look out for your loved ones. It's not even about you. You might want to go outside. Those people who are against it, they want to go outside. It's all me, you know. You've got to think of everybody. You've got to be more caring. You've got to be more just thoughtful.
Some people just don't want to wear a mask. Some people want to go to protests and not wear the mask and say their human rights are being infringed. They don't really believe necessarily the science behind the virus, and they're fed up too.
Now, the thing about them is that they're not even on Twitter, some of them. They're just kind of going out from word of mouth, and they're gathering in, like, wherever they'd be gathering, the pubs and stuff like that. And then they're going out there with...
Okay, they're watching right now. Hi, how are you? Okay, wear your mask. People are dying. People have died. People have not been able to go to funerals. They don't want to have their family members this Christmas. You wear your mask, change your ways, educate yourself. There's not conspiracies. You might be protesting or doing whatever and calling it a protest. It's not a protest if you're spreading a virus and not wearing a mask.
How do you feel about... You feel very passionate about this.
Yeah, right? Edward's very passionate.
I just feel like...
I've come to a realisation.
We've come to a realisation that some people just don't get it. And it's not even about masks. They stand for so many stuff that's wrong in the world. And it's just the tip of the iceberg. And this demographic of people that are marching in Dublin, there's so much anger in them. And I feel like they need to just...
We've got to move into the future. We've got to be accepting of everyone. And I feel they just want things to stay the way they were in the past, or whatever suits them. They don't want to move into the future. They don't want to live in the present day. They want to go, I want to go back there and do what
I
want.
And, like, I know you can have a debate and there's this side and that side, but when that other side's just completely wrong...
That's not a debate then, is it?
It's like... No one's learned how about this. This is the first time this ever happened in our generation, and probably the last, main here for a while.
What about the flack? You know, online is a pretty... it's a rough place to be, you know.
A lot of keyboard warriors. You got to stand your own 2 feet. You got to have your own opinion, stand by what you say.
I feel this pandemic has been the lowest for anyone. I've never felt so low in my life. I feel like everything's just out the door. What keeps you going is just focusing on what you should be doing, like making music, doing your job. Like,
this time has really, it's made you appreciate just being in one place at one time. It makes you realize what actually matters in your life, your family, your friends.
You know, a lot of people don't have family, and it's very hard for people working at home on their laptops, putting out articles, doing their jobs, and it's really demanding on your mental health. And I feel like we're the happiest people ever, and I feel like...
Like, it makes you get very deep down into your thoughts, and it makes you just want to, you know...
But you have too much time with your thoughts.
Well, that can be a problem for people. Like, I was talking to a psychologist there on the week on the radio who was talking about the level of anxiety about the place. Yeah. And he reckons, and I think he's right, you just said, Edward, that you felt really the lowest you've ever felt before. Like, and I think a lot of people your age and any age are feeling pretty low at the moment. But in some ways, the best thing to do about this is to talk about it, for starters. Yeah.
You just have to be optimistic and hopeful for the future. Because I feel like right now we're going through this, and it is bringing us all close together. And we can all reflect back when this has passed and just keep living and hanging in there to create those memories.
Trying to get people to do the right thing.
The thing is, people need to realize, you want to go to a club, you want to go to a bar, there is no future if this pandemic keeps going on, it spreads the virus.
But here's the question, how do you communicate to people who are not into it, not into social distance, not into really believing the COVID thing? How do you talk to, and I'm not just having to go at younger people, because it's not about that, it's about there's just sections of society who've just decided they're against it. So for example, the government might say, well actually the younger people we really need to kind of connect with here with the message.
I think the younger people
are influencers or whatever the hell it is.
No.
Are you into all that?
No, I feel like it's the younger people who are making, who want the rules to be followed. The younger people want the best for the future. They want everyone to be accepted. I feel the younger people in Ireland are the future of Ireland, obviously, because they're younger people, and the people who are the elders, because some of them are sitting there, you know, going, oh, well, I did this, I did that, I'll have it this way, I'll have it that way. But the younger people, they want change. They want the world to come together. And then you've got all these protests online where everyone connects.
I just wanted them to imagine. Imagine you're in hospital, your mom is suffering for 5 years from cancer, leukemia, and you're going to go in there and breathe on her face and give her COVID and make her suffer the consequence of all her organs.
There's so much fragile people around Ireland, and you've got to think of the older, the people, they're the characters, they're the ones who have the stories, they're the ones, the history of Ireland.
And they're pretty fed up too, having to be locked away if you're over 70, and they're not happy. So look, it's about trying to get the happy medium, but the bottom line is that simple message
about
what
communities are coming together, like they are looking out for each other. Like those people at home or might feel alone. Like there's people in the community looking after them that are aware of those people.
Will you talk to me about your mum?
Yeah.
Your mum, tell me about her.
Well, our mum 5 years ago found out that she had leukemia and kidney failure in the same day. So she was like 50, and she was like, and then she passed away. Like, it was all just a bit too much. But
when,
I like
did,
she,
when did she pass away?
I don't know all the specifics. I never done this
years,
but
last year.
It was very. The thing about it was that our mom kept living her life, even though she did have this, and she'd be going in, and she was getting dialysis as well, and other things as well, but this is the main cause of.
And the thing about it is, we were there when she passed, and it was, we're real thankful that we were there, able to hold her hand. We had, like, her in-earphones, listening to some music. And
what were you listening to?
We were listening to
some Fleetwood Mac, some of her favourite songs that she liked to play.
And the thing about it is, like, right now, my heart goes out to everyone who's not able to be with their loved ones who are passing and not able to go to a funeral.
It is really hard.
And tell me, first of all, condolences to you, right, and to your family. Because your mum was, you were close to your mum. Was she your manager as well? And she kind of minded you a bit?
Is her manager for
years.
Her
best interests at heart.
Yeah, no. Well, everyone who ever worked with us was just a face. They never actually didn't do a lot of things, but she always picked it back up.
I wouldn't say that. Our mom just always wanted us to go out there. She wasn't pushing us to do. She just wanted us to go out there and express ourselves and whatever we were, and she'd support us. She wasn't, you know, giving us false hope or giving us this. Moms, they want the best for you, but she wasn't like.
But she wasn't a mumsy mum where she's like coming home and cooking us dinner. Like, she was a teacher. She had her students. She had the stress of going to school and like, oh, I had to teach all these students today.
It's a lot of fun. Like, I always meet people, even here in the ORT studios, going, my mom taught me. And
And but tell me this. How are you doing? Because this is a big thing.
Yeah,
when your mother passes away,
it is.
This is a void and a vacuum in your lives that is very hard to explain unless you've lost a parent.
Yeah.
How have you both been? Because this is not an easy time.
It's really hard because you got relationships and stuff, and you realize that your mom's never going to get to see your kids.
Yeah, it's very disheartening to think that she won't be at our wedding, she won't be there for the birth of our kids. But we always keep her spirit alive, like have pictures of her around and like tell stories. And I don't know, you just feel so disconnected from the world because the person that kept you anchored in the world, who gave birth to you, is gone. And now you don't know where you should be, what you should be doing, and someone who actually has a genuine opinion on you.
Of course.
But our mom's sisters, Bernadette and Geraldine, like, they're very supportive, and they're like moms to us as well, so we have them, you know, keeping an eye on us, and if we never need a conversation.
And I feel like the last year has made us grow up because we've had to just get everything together, music, and just.
We've always been organized, making things happen, but it really does like sweep the carpet underneath you, and it makes you just go, wow. Like,
you kind of feel a little unanchored.
Yeah.
A little bit.
Yeah, but at the same time, she still wants us to keep going, and she wants us to keep living, and because that's what she was doing, even though she did have these disease.
When you, looking back, you're obviously reflecting a lot at the moment with all of the things that are going on in your life.
Yeah.
And you're nearly, 10 years or thereabouts in the business, and do you know, do you feel, I mean, I've pretty much known you in the 10 years, obviously professionally like
11 years.
Do you feel, that life has changed dramatically for you both? Do you feel more like men than the boys?
Well, look at this hair and the chest here.
Well, congratulations, John. That's great news.
I'll give you some, Ryan.
I need some.
No, you go through the motions. Like, there's times when you got to be serious, and times when you got to just have a bit of fun, let loose. And I feel like we're like diamonds. There's different sides to us all the time, and we just
there's a lot of stuff that goes on behind the scenes that the public wouldn't know.
Like what?
You always have to keep a united front.
You have to organize and customize your clothes. You gotta have little meetings.
I'm talking about way more serious stuff. Like, it's very competitive.
Then there's a lot of politics. You know, I feel like me and Ed, we're just free spirits. We've got good intentions. We keep going, even if people aren't shining the light on us. We keep there for our fans, making music, playing guitar.
The thing about it is, like, going over the years, you have to not lose that spark and the love for doing it, because usually people can lose that spark and they're overworked, and sometimes we have time to, like, we're out there, then we'll take a step back.
You just got to find and stay true to your morals. Our mom and our granddad, whoever
we're not angels.
But they give you those solid morals in life, as long as you just know what you're about and who you are when you meet people personally or wherever it so happens to be, and you keep those, you don't lose the run of yourself.
And you remain friends.
Oh, twins, how are you?
Yeah, we have our moments. We have our moments still. We still have our twin moments where I'm like, oh, you know.
I think in the beginning we were more like the twin Jedward thing.
Because we didn't know what we were doing from the beginning. We weren't in stage school. We weren't dance. We didn't know. We were propelled out there straight onto these shows. No one would give us a brief of what's going to happen, what are we going to talk about. You naturally enough just be like, so you know,
just
what I mean?
Go for it.
You know, I'm a winger.
Make a toy show. John ripping his pants.
Yeah. I remember that too. But it's funny talking to you. You know, I'm definitely seeing the evolution of the two boys who, as I say, are men.
We're always pushing and reinventing.
And you know, I saw you rehearsing the song you're going to sing for us earlier on, and I thought something's changing. I think when people watch this song tonight, they're going to see you in a different light.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because what you're about to do now is thoughtful, it's reflective, and actually I was going to say it's kind.
Yeah.
Because you've chosen a beautiful song. Why don't you tell us what song you've chosen? Why?
I chose a song because I feel it's all about hope, and even when you're feeling alone, that like everybody hurts, everyone goes through these emotions in life.
And I think like this song, the message is stronger than ever because some people are at home and this is going to uplift them.
And the days are long and they are stretched out, and you can listen to the lyrics as we're singing them and just know that we're coming from a genuine place. We want to get that message.
But we also want to dedicate the song to our mom because we haven't had the opportunity to be on TV since her passing, and I think it would be a nice way to say we love you.
That's a beautiful thing to do. Do you want to head over and get ready to sing?
Thanks, Ryan.
Hey, listen, it's good to see you.
Yeah.
Thanks,
don't
Ryan.
Be surprised. Good to see you. You're looking younger than ever. We're with a new record. We'll give it to you.
Keep us posted. It's good to see you. And I see your auntie's here. So your mum's spirit lives on here with you. So, lads, make your way over. It's great to see you, fellas. John and Edward, mind yourselves, and thanks for coming in tonight. And as the lads make their way over to perform this, listen in for this and watch in for this. I think you're going to really love it. It's a beautiful song dedicated, like they say, to their mother, Susanna. It's Jedward's, with their take on that R.E.M. beautiful classic, Everybody Hurts.
Life, hang on.
there, boys. That was beautiful. Ah, well done. Jedward, that was really gorgeous. And fair play to you. Thanks for coming in to do that. It was a really lovely thing to do. Jedward's album, Voice of a Rebel, is on release now. Whew. Okay, regroup. Everyone's back at school. I'm no exception. I have spent...